Welcome back to Empyrion Galactic Survival. I'm the Radio Man 03. It is awesome to have you along. We are heading into space to see if we can find some of those drones to get some of those power coils for the advanced constructor. If I don't get them on this round, if I don't get a couple, and I don't even want to build the thing right now. I want to hold on to it until we get our big base, but I want to have it available to us when we do pick the area for our large base. So today's going to be kind of twofold. We're going to come up here into space. I'm going to put my helmet on just to be safe. Refilled the oxygen. We've got the food and everything else, so we're doing pretty good. I just want it for the new base. That's what I want it for. And, wow. That seemed like a kind of a rough little approach into space. The ship was shaking pretty hard. Okay, there is a space station right there of some sort. That is really big, too. It looks really big. I want to look for a drone here in the asteroid belt. Let's get out here so we can see a little bit better. You guys can see better, I can see better. To try to get the parts we need to make that advanced constructor. What I am becoming very aware of in this game is that it is very in-depth. They have created so many different things for you to do that it is unbelievable to me. It's just so much you can do. And I think I'm just trying to go too fast, really. I've said this before, but I do believe that's the case. I'm trying to go too fast. But I would like to get the stuff for the advanced constructor taken care of, at least the parts for it, have it built, put it in a chest, and have it ready to go so when we do find location for our base, we'll have it ready to go. And I'm hoping that this asteroid belt, if anything else, we'll go down to the moon and we'll find there. But we did get one here in the asteroid belt, and I'm hoping we might bump into another drone out here somewhere. Or go down to the moon. Some of you have said you should have built your base in the moon. Just a reminder that this base is just a temporary base. It is not our permanent base. We are going to build, and I do think I want to try something inside. Have it hang inside and outside of a mountain. Have like the hangar inside and have like some living quarters on the outside, so we can see that too. I think that would be really cool. Kind of coming up. Empty on the drones, aren't we? Last time we were up here, we ran into one right away. It's kind of cool. You can see some of the planets way off in the distance. On the other side of the asteroid field here, there's a planet way out there. What do we got here? Sathium. Okay, that's Sathium. Yeah, okay. That's the asteroid. I believe that's the one we did some harvesting on. This is going to make things much harder to see now that the sun is going to be in our eyes. Oh, what do we got here? We have two arrows here. Space drone. There we go. That's our target, ladies and gentlemen. Better, huh? Okay, let's go up. Let's get into third or first person so we get nice and close to this. Okay, I should be able to. I got my jetpack is off. There it is. That's just what the doctor ordered right there. Since that went relatively smooth, let's see about finding us another one. We'll see if we can find another drone out here just so we've got some extra parts. Maybe we could put an advanced one here in this base and then have one in our other base as well. I'll zoom back out again so you guys can see. I believe we're kind of backtracking where we just were. The moon might be a better place for us to go get drones. Let's try it. Let's see. We've got plenty of fuel, so let's go down there and take a look and see what we can do. I'll try to stay on the sunny side of the moon so that we can see better. Which means I probably got to turn this around. Zoom. There we go. Awesome. That is so fun. A quick little roll. Okay, so we've got some of the power coils now. That's a good thing. I'm gonna drink of my hot coffee here. If I haven't said it, I hope you're all doing fantastic. I am doing great. Welcome to the new subscribers. It is great to have you on board. Thank you so much for stopping by and checking out the channel and signing up. I do appreciate it very, very much. And we're gonna cut in. We're gonna cut right into the atmosphere here. I see the border around the north here. We need to avoid that. There we go. And then we're gonna head this direction. Get ourselves in the sunlight. And we'll get ourselves a little bit closer to the surface of the moon as well, so we can see iron deposit. Oh, you know, I did not know this stuff was on here. If I hit map... Okay, that pulls up the moon. Look at all this stuff. Cesium, silicon, copper, cobalt. Okay, everything that's on the regular planet is down here as well. Plus some more. I guess we could have built our world, our base right up here on the moon, huh? Iron deposit. Okay, very good. Okay, so that's good to know. I did not know that. Let me ask you this. Do you guys know, Cesium, beautiful, if I put, there's the auto mining machines that they recently introduced to the game. If I put those out, will they be attacked by enemy drones and stuff? I'm assuming they would be, because they are going to be, you know, pretty much attached to us and have our imprint on it. So I'm curious about that, because I'm willing to set up things to protect them, of course. No drones yet, but look at that beautiful sunrise. Oh my god. Wow, what a barren wasteland. Lots of blue crystal, though. This is where we're going to be coming for our hyperdrive stuff. Look at all that. That is pretty sweet. Ah, here we go. Rocket drone. Rocket drone. Okay, he didn't have anything like we really wanted on there. So that's not quite right. He did damage the ship, too. He did hit us. Silicon. What else do we have here? Rocket drone. Okay. I just forgot to check that mini-map. So there's a rocket drone, but that is not... It looks like the plasma drone, maybe. And why weren't my guns armed by me? That is... Oh, I guess once you get out of the ship and get back in the ship, you've got to push it again. That's a good note to self. Every time you get in the ship, arm your weapons. Yeah, I think I want to do a little bit of building today as well and see if we can't get... Awesome. Whoosh. Awesome. Look at that. There's Akua. Akua, the home planet. Yeah, I don't know if these guys are going to have what we want. There's a base right over here, too. Who's firing at us? Let's get out of range. Hopefully. Wow, he's still shooting at us. There's another base over here. Holy crap, there's a lot of them. That looks like a drone base, just like the one we've got on our planet. Oh my god, what is that? Oh geez, get the hell out of here. What is that thing right there? Up and down, up and down. Oh my god. Please don't hit me and shoot me out of the sky. Oh my god. Evasive action. Oh my god, I'm pushing our luck. Oh my god, and I don't have any. That's pretty crazy. Oh boy. Okay, that's some kind of crashed ship back there. That's just an abandoned ship, but of course it's got things watching it, so that's expected. Now that we know that. Well, let's go back up to the asteroid belt and see if there's anything else we can do. Ghost Rider base. Found another base down here too, so there's gonna be all kinds of stuff on our map now, that's for sure. Holy cow. That border, it's a pain in the butt, man. I hope they find a way to work around that so we don't have to have that anymore. That'd be great. You guys have explained that. Explained what that's for. Apparently these planets aren't really round. They're just flat, but that's why those are there. Back into space where I feel a little bit safer. Look at these planets out here. That's pretty cool. Look at that. So that's 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It must be 7 main planets with moons on them, huh? So, because Empyrion numerically means 7. So that's got to be what it means, right? There's our moon. Where is our planet? There it is. Boy, they got some nerve, man. They were shooting at us like crazy. Holy cow. Whew. Okay. Let's see if we can find us one more rocket drone. We're going to go ahead and follow the asteroid belt here a little bit. It was dark back on the planet. It had just, the sun was just getting ready to go down. So that's why I decided to come out here. We'll kill a little time. Hopefully the sun will be coming up by the time we land. And we won't have to be working in the dark. That was kind of my goal. Always thinking about you, the subscriber. Want to make sure the daylight's out there so we can see what we're doing. It's true. It's very true. Give me one more of those guys. Oof, that was a close one. Mama. I think I've had a close call every episode. 2 deaths and a lot of close calls. You know, what do? You gotta figure it out somehow, right? Sometimes you just gotta throw caution to the wind and go out there and give it a shot and see what happens. We do have to watch out for that alien space base out here, though. That thing is a pain in the butt. We don't want that happening to us. Not until we get our capital ship. What do we got here? Okay, that's Sathium. It's really cool. This asteroid belt is very awesome. Know how the ship feels when you're flying it and stuff, you know? This one feels a little slow. I don't know, maybe it's not. Maybe it's just right for me. If I was going any faster, I probably would have plowed right into we'll call it the force field, the barrier. There's that big ship out in the sky. Out in space, the sky. Safe to get out of here. There was that space station. Okay, looks like we're good to go. All right, let's pull up a little bit. Nice, 5 of them in there. Arm the weapons. We are out of here. We are going back home. We'll do our best to stay out of range of that base. We've got the coils we need. I think we'll check and see how many we have, and then see if we can go ahead and pull off making one of those advanced constructors. Because that has been our goal for the last three episodes, and I think we may have just done it. Ooh, entering the atmosphere, yes. Checking the map to see where we are. Okay, we want to go kind of a southeasterly direction. Very dark out. Ah, but success. The ship took a little bit of damage. I will go around the ship with the, is it the multi-tool? The multi-tool, and I will repair it on my own. No problems there. There's the Talon Guardian Village, so yeah, we're right over this way somewhere. Yeah, it's still nighttime. Too far over this way. We should be, I think we're right around this peak here, in between these peaks. There's our lake right there, I believe, in front of us. Probably hard for you guys to see. Nasty spiders. How dare they teach me a lesson. There's the base. Beautiful. All right, guys. Tell you what, I'm going to land, get inside, unload our stuff, get some things kind of put together, and then I'll come back and we will resume with the episode. So stick around. Welcome back. Great news. We can now do the advanced constructor. We have three power coils. This takes two, so we're going to have one left. It looks to me like until we get the materials, the two materials that aren't available on this planet, or on the moon apparently, it's going to be a while. We're going to have to keep, I guess, killing the space drones in order to get them, because these guys take Erestrum and Zascosium. Zascosium and a restroom ingot, so neither one of those are within this area, so that means we have to jump to another planet in order to get those. So I'll look on the wiki, or you guys could tell me what planet those are on, and that's going to be our goal, is to be able to get those two materials most definitely. But this guy, here we go, this is going to open everything up to us, I believe, and that's a positive thing. Now the other thing I want to look at real quick before we start doing a little building is I learned the sniper rifle, no, assault rocket launcher. I thought I learned the plasma rifle. The multi-tool tier 2 must be available inside this guy, because I don't see it in here to build. I could have sworn, oh, here's the pulse rifle. Power coil times 2. Power coil times 2. Okay, so yeah, we can't make that. Yeah, so we're definitely going to want one of those power coils. They're going to be very, very important to us. Definitely important to us. So, okay, let's go ahead and move on with the day. We're not going to place that guy just yet, because I'm not quite sure where we're going to put the door. I know this is going to have to move. This is probably going to move over to this wall here, and we're going to put a door on this side. But let's go on outside and see just what it is we could do in terms of building. It's kind of a little farm area for the food and stuff. I think we might be okay out here. I am going to take a look in the immediate area to see if maybe we've got any trouble we need to watch out for. Now that we know that the raptors don't come at us unless it's the night one, we're pretty good to go. You guys were a huge help. You told me that there's several ways of building here. We could see now that we've got a block issue right there. I mean, we've got structural integrity. If we go to N and we go structural integrity, we've got structural integrity here, but you can see those blocks are now on the ground. I did not even notice that before. Now, I was told there's two options for this. Number one, we can take this block, and if we hold down left click, it allows us to sink the block into the ground, but that does not seem to be the case right there. Huh. Also, I was told that if I take our drone out, F5, I can actually come down and get up underneath here. That's not putting it up underneath there either. Yeah, I wonder if it's because I've already got the land kind of messed up underneath here. F5 out. Let's see. What did that do? Yeah, that just placed the block right there. So, I don't know. Am I doing something wrong here? Let me know. I'm gonna bring that ground up underneath here. You know, you got birds singing and stuff like that, but I tell you what, there's a bunch of creepy stuff flopping around out here too. Man, this game really keeps you on edge. I love it. We're not going to build a huge farm area, but one that's big enough for us to, of course, you know, have some good farms in. Enough to get some decent plants and stuff that we need. Let's see if that's going to be enough for this right here. We want to start right here. Let's break that back out again, and we will get up underneath here. Go like so. All right, beautiful. How many blocks is that right there? Let's see, how many did we just put down here? That's one, two, three, four, five, six. Okay, that's six. Six. Let's go seven. Eight. Nine. So that's going to give me... Okay, so we come out the door. We have a block to stand on. And then we've got one, two, three planters. So we're going to have room for three... Okay, we've got room here. So let's continue this out. Oh, you know what we need? We need the planter blocks. Let's go ahead and take this guy out, and let's punch a hole. I believe we could punch a hole right here and get in. Yeah, there we go. Beautiful. Okay, perfect. We have some... I have some... whatchamacallits made already. Planter blocks. What did I do with them? I didn't put them in the fridge, did I? Are they in here still? Growing plot. I had some growing plots. I made them already. Are they in here? That's weird. I could have sworn I made like 8 or 9 of them already. Let me take a look again. Nothing in the cargo box. Okay. There they are. Aha! There we go. There's 9 of them right there. Perfect. Okay, let's do that, and then let's get these guys out here and kind of figure out where we're going to set these guys up at. Okay, so we want one... Let's see here, we're going to do a... One, two, three... This should allow, what is it, you guys told me it was a 3x3 area that these one grow light will do. So that's not even a 3x3 right there. So then we could do another one of those right there. There's 9 right there. Okay, beautiful. Okay, so we need 9 more of those. How many more of those can we make? What's it take? Fiber 2, nutrient solutions 1. We have 1 nutrient solution. What's a nutrient solution? It is rock dust, purified water, and spoiled food. Oh, we've got plenty of spoiled food, so we're good there. Purified water, we're good there. And what was the other ingredient on that? Rock dust. Oh, perfect. Okay, great. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, awesome. Alright, then what we're going to do is we're going to put a little bit of a gap. I don't know if this is going to be anything too fancy. Next one we do, though, I've got some ideas for design that I want to do with this. But this is just to get us kind of started here. So it's kind of overdue is what this is, I think. It's probably very overdue. I think you guys would agree with that. Let's put a 2 wide in between here. So we're going to have to go 1, 2, 3. And we've got 2 blocks down on that end between... Yeah, between the wall and here. So let's do another 2 here. So that's 1 Plant, plant, plant. Walkway, walkway. Let's get our leveler out. This guy's pretty cool. Boom. Get those plants out of here. That's such a nice feature, too. Get to keep the plants from being inside your build. I think that's pretty cool that they included this. So you can get the grass out of the way. One thing in medieval engineers that's always bothered me is that sometimes you can't do anything about the fact that the plants are going to be in your build. And so what we should do here too is have a double whammy as well. Yeah, just like so. And we're going to bring this across here. Give me one more. There we go. Thank you very much. All right. I love the building on here. As I get better at it, it's going to be so much better. Whoa, hey, what the heck? Well, that ruined the ground, didn't it? So actually, we've got a one-way walkway here. We don't have two on the back side, though. Oh, boy. Okay, that is uneven. Here, let's do this. Come on, there we go. Why is it doing that? Crazy. We got plenty of materials to make more crops, so we're good to go. We'll see how far we can get on this today. Yeah, okay, beautiful. And then a wall here. Come on, bring it up. Did I lose it? I did. Like so. There we go. And we're going to come this way with it. We're actually going to fill this in right here. And we're going to take these guys out of here. I think the next goal I have is to step up to the tier 2 multi-tool as well. I would like to have this guy beefed up as well. I think it would take a lot less time to bust these out. Whoops. So we need three more of these, right? Three more. One, two, three. What the heck? What's... Where are my grow plots at? That's weird. What did I do? What did I do wrong there? Am I not seeing them? Give me some more steel plates. I have three. Do I have enough now to do this? What's this made out of? Rock dust, spoiled food, purified... Well, that's what I was looking at. Okay. Fiber, nutrient solution. Okay, so now we should have enough to do it. Okay. I was looking at the wrong thing. Oh, boy. I tell you. Sometimes I think I play with my eyes crossed. Okay, let's get these guys out there and get them started before the sun goes down. We still have 7 minutes. We're doing pretty good. We're doing all right. Okay, so this goes here, here, and here. And we've got three left. This should be quite a bit of food, I would think, to kind of sustain us here. I don't even know if we've got enough stuff to plant in the crops, but I believe we can make seeds if we want to, which is pretty cool. Let's get this going. Uh, Yeah, that's beautiful. Okay, we're going to put some windows in here too. I've not messed around with the windows very much, so we're going to play around with the windows a little bit as well. And I didn't need to make this many. Maybe I did. Yeah, I did. Six more. Awesome. Okay, so we've got those guys now. Now we need... You said one grow light does a 3x3, so I should need two grow lights for this, right? Do we have grow lights available to us in here? Did I learn the grow light? Well, let's see. Grow light. Was it right here? No, it should be maybe base? Plant grow light, okay. There it is. One, two of those. How are we doing on blocks? We got 785 blocks. We're doing pretty good on the blocks. We should be okay there. And the next episode, I think what we need to do is we just need to get the base looking sharper. We need to give it... We need to give it some personality, guys. We really do. It's right now, it's just a box, you know? What's going on here? There we go. Must have been that little piece of weed there, huh? What? What? Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Give me another grow plot. I'm missing steel plates again. Steel plates. And in you go. Give me one of those. Come on. Let's do it. Let's do it. Looks to me like you get everything back when you destroy something. That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. Okay, let's get you in there. All right. Awesome. Okay, so F5. Can I go inventory? I can. Awesome. Put those guys right in here. Let's get this wall finished up. We'll come back and put windows in it afterwards. Come on, why are you acting so weird here all of a sudden? I tell you, it's getting used to this is what it is. And I think if I were to spend about 6 hours just building, I would probably get this down pretty well. With anything, practice makes perfect, right? And then we'll check structural integrity, and I'll get that fixed up as well. There we go. By the way, no drone attacks at all for quite some time now that I'm aware of. I haven't heard that gun turret go off at all. Guess that's hoping for too much there, huh? What? Whoa. There we go, and across the top, and we know now that we can come up here and do that. And what I can do is I can hold control, and I can fill this whole thing in. Oh, that did not work. Let's try that again. I'm trying to get this figured out. There we go. Did I get it all? Missed a spot. Missed a spot. Come on now. There we go. Yeah, I'm taking you guys with me just to kind of show you. I guess there is a bit of a struggle with it to get used to it. Okay, so now here we need our grow light. One right there, right? And probably two down would work. Or is that too low? Let's go inventory. Let's get these guys in, get these guys out. And we're going to put you right there. That's going to work, I guess. That's going to work right there. Okay, beautiful. We've got our plants. Now we're going to need lights. Let's see. Next episode, we're going to get this place all decorated and stuff. This is just to get things up and running right now today. But we'll do the windows and stuff next episode. Let's see here. We're going to get plants planted, though, today and get some lighting put in here. So what do we have here for a wall? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, about 8 lights is what we need. And let's go back to here probably. No, here, 8 lights, yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And we'll make 2 more just because we'll probably make mistakes. Makes sense to me. Yeah, the decorating part, I'm really looking forward to it. I've got some ideas, guys, especially for the next base. If I forgot to mention it, it's going to be... I want to be closer to a mountain and build into a mountain and be on the outside of the mountain as well. So when you approach the base, you've got both views. And on the inside, I want some of the rock to still show. You know, I want it to be like that... you know, like the James Bond bases that the bad guys live in, where they're walking around. You've still got the stone cave around you, but you've got, you know, catwalks and walkways and staircases and stuff in there. That's kind of where my imagination's going with it. I think that would be really cool to have something like that. All right, here we go. We're almost there, guys. Thanks for being patient with me. I know I'm a little bit slow on the uptake here, but it's coming along. It's coming along. You know, you play a game like Minecraft, like I've been playing that for 6 years now, and you don't have to even think hardly anymore about what it is you're doing when you're making stuff, because it just comes natural to you. But having these games like this is really a great experience for me. I'm really enjoying it very much, very much. And your support has been much appreciated. All right, let's go ahead and right-click, and this looks just like the grow light, doesn't it? It sure does. This one is round, we know that. This one's flat, more for like the ground, I think. We're going to go with the ones that we've been using. And we'll go ahead and spin that around and click it into place. Let's see. How long is this right here? This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You know what? I want it right here. I want one right here. They sure aren't putting off much light, are they? What's going on with that? And we're going to put one right here. And we're going to put one... Am I standing in the middle here? I am, okay. Like that. And one more right over here. That's really weird. What is this? What are these set on? P. Oh, it's dropped them down to... We'll go 10 meters with it. I wonder why these guys... I guess because they're just on the base. That seems really weak to me, though. Very, very weak. Two. Range. That doesn't really do much, does it? Let's take a look at this again. It's almost like it all of a sudden kind of changed on me as to how well these lights were working where I had them before. I guess we could do that with all of these right here. So 2, range 10. 2, range 10. To range 10, okay, and then let's let's do that one and that one as well. That one's good. That one's good. We're good there. We're good there. And that should be good right there. I think we can do the individual ones. If we come up here and hit P on this one, it takes us right to the one that we're looking at. And we can actually adjust just that one. So I think that's going to be what we do here real quick. And right here, P. There we go. And up to two. Come on. That's pretty picky right there. Pretty finicky when you move that around. There we go. All right. Sweet. All right. Good deal. All right. So let's get the lights out of our inventory. Let's get this out of here. Let's get this multi-tool out of here. We're probably a little bit hungry. We'll eat something while we go get some seeds. Yeah. Nice, nice, big, juicy salami. Mm-hmm. I turn these lights down. They seemed really intense back in here, and I do like the blue glow of that. We have a tomato. We have a durian sprout. A tomato sprout. Three corn sprouts. So that's great. I want the corn for the plastic. The wheat sprout. What else do we have here? Pearthing sprout and aloe vera sprout. What's this one? A pumpkin sprout. I'm not going to plant those. Kava beans. Let's start with these guys right here. I think we're going to want more tomatoes and stuff like that, because I believe there is some really good food items in here. There is a, sounds gross, but canned meat, raw meat, tomatoes, purified water, and steel plate. And then we have a canned vegetables as well, space durians and pumpkins. Oh, food, 150, health, 10. Parish time 350. This is a parish time of 350. These are both the same. So you know what? Let's get that pumpkin seed and let's go ahead and put that pumpkin seed in. Why not? Yep. There we go. All right. Beautiful. Now, if we kill the talons, they carry seeds on them. So I guess we could do that. I killed the ones because I was panicked. I was dying. So I slaughtered them. I did. I slaughtered them. Let's go to 7. I think I want... 7. Corn, corn, corn. And then we're going to go wheat in this row, and we'll throw the pumpkins over here, like so. Tab, and let's go ahead and do the tomatoes. And we have a... space cave durian sprout. I want at least 3 tomatoes, too. We could look and see just exactly what we need to do this. That's the tomato, right? Tomato. You can go right here. And the durian can go right there. That durian looks like an onion. That's crazy looking. Very cool. Okay, so we've got some plants going now. Some food. What does it take to make seeds, you guys? What do we need to make 2 more tomato plants? Tomato sprout. We need tomatoes. Oh, purified water and nutrient solution. Okay, well, we've got that. Yeah, we sure do. We have one of those. So let's go ahead and make... How much spoiled food do we have? We have... Well, we have plenty of it. Let's make another 20 of those. I'll make 25. We're going to get those going. We got that going now. Is there any other seeds that we have that we could possibly plant? Kava beans. Can we plant the kava bean? Did we just plant a kava bean? This is the pear thing sprout. Is this something we can plant? I believe this makes that coffee drink, and who the heck doesn't want some of that? No, you don't plant that. Okay, all right. There it is, though. We've got some corn, some wheat. I would like to get 2 more wheat going as well. And then the pumpkin, I think we're good with that one, but I definitely want more tomatoes. Uh-oh. Missed a piece of grass right here. I'll have to get that. Yeah. And then, yeah, next episode we are going to be doing some decor work. Oh, we were going to check the integrity of the base here. Let's see. The roof is a little sketchy, so is this, but that's not going to go anywhere, I don't think. We've got a good foundation. Looks like the roof is a bit... Oh, this is... Okay, that's because we've got this gap right here. If we put a door here, we'll be fine. But I don't want to put a door here right now, because what I want to do is... Let's get out of this mode right here. I want to move this this guy right here is going to go over. We're going to make a new one and put it over on this wall over here. And then we'll put our door in the middle here that leads out to the garden area. And then when we come back next episode, we're going to work on decorating the base, getting some glass installed, sprucing it up, making it look really nice. And we'll get to start using these guys right here because we're just run out of time today. The texture and simple tool and the color tool, we'll use those. I'm really looking forward to that as well. So I think that's going to wrap it up for me. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed today's episode. I did. I had a fun time. I had a great time putting it together. And like I said, next episode, we'll do more work on the base. We'll stay here, and we'll get creative with some of the blocks and some of the items that they have in the game. So if you enjoyed today's episode, do hit that like button for me. I'd appreciate it very much. Comment, subscribe, and share. Welcome to the new subscribers. It is great to have you on board. Have an awesome, fantastic, and superb day, and I look forward to talking to you again next time.